This is the show made by 20-somethings for 20-somethings.
For people who have been there, done that,
or thought about it. It could be fantastic.
It could suck.
It could be phenomenal. We are making this up as we go along. This is an experiment.
This is who we is.
We're a bunch of 20-somethings.
Good morning, afternoon, evening, depending on where you are. I'm Amelia.
I'm Matt.
I'm Joe, and we hope you're having a wonderful day.
I'm Mandy, and welcome to 20-somethings TV.
So today we have some really cool topics for all of you. Matt, you want to tell us?
Yeah, starting off is Coachella, the music festival that just ended this past weekend. Oh. So did you guys listen to or see any of the shows?
No, I was pretty depressed about it. I just didn't want to think about it.
Did you at least watch the Snapchat when it was, because they had a Snapchat event going on, the whole thing, so you could literally just skim
yeah,
through.
Yeah, I looked at some of those. They had these masks on that were like big emoji faces, but like eyes like popped out, so you were like, hard eyes, and it was really scary actually. It kind of reminded me of that movie where they all wear animal masks and then kill all the people.
You're next.
Didn't watch.
Okay. Yeah. Did you guys? I just the trailer was scary enough, you know.
Did you guys see Madonna kissing Drake in his face afterwards? He was not into it.
He was not.
I didn't watch it. I just saw the picture of them making out, and then I felt like it.
She's working really hard on that comeback.
So pretty much.
I don't think she has to try as hard as she is.
Maybe. I mean, is she relevant anymore?
I think it's her.
Madonna's always relevant.
I mean, I think you know she's. I think she does some cool stuff. I just think you know you don't have to go make out with like a young man to like.
Oh yeah, she's old.
True.
So Coachella was
not age shame.
A lot like You're Next. And next on our agenda
is Tidal. Tidal is that the new music software, similar to Spotify, but like 10 times more expensive and unnecessary. Are you guys thinking you're going to get it? Or
No.
I don't even pay for Spotify.
It's just a bunch of rich people like making money still. So there's really
there's
no difference. Because
like,
the artists aren't getting any more money.
Yeah, because it's only a few artists. Like, it's not everyone.
No, it's just really rich people already.
Yeah, it's like Jay-Z
making more money.
Yeah.
And like those artists don't have a problem with Spotify in the beginning because they are already making money compared to
that. Well, because Jay-Z founded it, right?
Tidal. Yeah, he created it and he was just all his rich friends kind of went from there.
But like, I don't even understand why it's
I'm a big
like,
Kanye man myself, though.
Okay.
No, still mad at him after the Taylor Swift thing.
They apologize, you know that.
I know. She wrote a song for him. Still not
really?
Into it. Yeah.
It's all very true.
But speaking of craziness, Game of Thrones.
Yeah,
premiere.
Let me tell
you
a little
it?
Bit about
don't
it.
Don't even spoil it, because I didn't even watch it yet. And I need to go on HBO Go and watch
let
it
let me just tell you what. The fire gets hot. The fire gets hot. Oh,
phrase.
Yeah, baby. You know what I'm talking about.
You guys watch
you
Game
saw
of
that episode.
No, I don't.
Oh, it's incredible. It has everything you need in a real TV show. Incest, royalty, more incest.
I'll tell you one spoiler. A guy fingers his sister. It happens.
Welcome
not going
to 20-somethings TV.
Weird,
on a lighter note, though, Corgi Beach Day was this past weekend.
Yes!
Southern California.
It was a hell of a day.
Mandy feels very passionately about
yeah,
it.
I love corgis. Like, I want to get one and be just like the
me
queen.
Too.
And maybe we should get a corgi together sometime.
But we were watching the video earlier, and it didn't have just corgis.
No.
Made it a little
somebody
weird.
Brought their other types of dogs. Like, it's Corgi Beach
like
Day.
Lab,
what
like,
are you
like,
doing?
Corgis on the beach.
Golden
the
Retriever. Waves. And they were running faster than the corgis to make them look bad. Like, no, it's about tiny dogs at the beach.
With midget legs.
No, yeah.
I just don't know why we have to discriminate against dogs. They're all very huggable.
Yeah, but it would be a
no,
dog beach day.
Corgis are corgi different, though.
Day.
They're the dog of royalty.
They're like the midget dog.
Yeah.
You guys ever seen the corgi flop?
No.
Well, it's flopping to be seen, so you guys should check that out.
But apparently they do this every year. Like, this is the ninth time they've had Corgi Beach Day.
So next
and,
year
like, thank you to whoever came up with that, because that's just incredible.
I just always want to bring my dogs to the beach, but whenever I think I can do that, it's always, like, actual beach season, so I'm not allowed to do that. But.
So grab a Gordon's London Dry Gin, grab your dog, if he's a corgi, go drink at the beach.
I'll
it's
be there.
It's going to be a hell of a day.
I don't know, I just think they look awkward, but speaking of awkward, we're moving on to Flinch, which is an extremely uncomfortable new app that just came out. We were playing it earlier, so it pretty much it goes that you can verse anyone in the world, and you camera, like, you face them, face-to-face camera, and you can't smile. And it sounds simple, but then you do it, and we were like with the Saudi Arabian man for about 20 minutes.
I'm going to let you finish.
Things got weird.
But we were verbally assaulted by this Saudi Arabian man. They kept screaming, and then it was my turn.
It affected her on a deep level.
This man was like, "We want to touch you."
I asked him what his mother would think about that.
So yeah, it's supposed to be that you're supposed to make them laugh, but then you have friends that go in the game too and start yelling in the background. So there was like six of us in the room, and then these two Saudi Arabian 30-year-old men that we were roasting.
They were doing everything. They were smoking. They were screaming. It was very alarming. I don't know. Maybe
they didn't do a lot of smiling. That footage.
No smiling though.
We did have a picture of one of them smiling, and the software didn't catch it. So they were cheating.
The software catches the smile, so all you have to do is like frown or not laugh, and then you like either draw or neither of you win.
That was bizarre.
You smile and then you lose.
Quite bizarre.
So we're not allowed to do that on the app.
So that about wraps up our show for this week. But stay tuned each week and follow us on our social medias.
Which is Instagram at 20somethingsTV and our website, 20somethingsTV.com. Also, PSA, given the Flinch app, please practice appropriate internet safety. Don't talk to strangers. Only talk to people you feel comfortable with, and maybe ask your parents for some advisory.
All right. Thank you guys so much for tuning each week. Bye.
Be safe.
Tell me how we got this far. Every man for himself. Everything's gone to hell. We gotta stay strong. We're gonna hold on. This world is turned to dust. Oh, we've